Hello everybody, this is going to be a fairly quick one because I'm just going to be looking at pictures of two, these are official LEGO pictures, official pictures from LEGO of two new sets that are coming out from the creator line, and these are from promobricks.de, who brought them in from a couple of different online retailers that have made them public. So all thanks to promobricks.de, and you'll be seeing these propagating all around the internet, and hopefully we'll be getting more pictures as well. But let me get right into this with the new creator Ferris Wheel. That's a small one, so something much more attainable than the last one we got. So I'm happy to see that. Set number 31119. It comes with 1,002 pieces, 1,002 pieces, interestingly, and the expected retail price is €90 or $90 US as a 3-in-1. You know, you get the main build, but it also has official builds for bumper cars, the nicest looking bumper cars I think that LEGO has officially brought out to date. I'm very happy to see that. Big fan of bumper cars. I think bumper cars are a good thing, just generally speaking. Very colorful here. Not sure if they're going to have the full cage over this. It's probably going to be open in the back. I don't have a back of the box photo for this, unfortunately, but yeah, I got a little ticket booth there. This dude is doing some juggling of hammers. Not safe. And these are just some little swings, like a triple swing ride. I don't remember the name of what that type of thing is called in particular, but I think it looks decent. These are going to rock, right? They're going to rock back and forth. And then this, I don't know what... Oh, it's a claw machine. I think it's supposed to represent a small claw machine. This is the best quality photo that I personally have seen to date. But the main build, it's so much smaller than the previous major creator expert one. So much smaller. But has most of the functionality. Each of these little gondolas is going to carry only a single figure. That's the big thing. That's the big thing that you lose in scaling down like this. Otherwise, the overall build structure and build strategy is very, very similar. It's just sized down. All these little built-up balloons are nice. Little dog there, kind of classic-styled torso for this one. Colorful ticket booth. All this looks very nice to me. And this is a picture of just slightly different angle, slightly more realistic look. I'm not sure if there's anything additional that you can see here. I've not been staring at these pictures to see, is there any one thing that's really special? Like, I recognize that part to get it in white is good. I want more of those. These pieces in white also, no. So those are just clips. Those are like Exoforce hands. But is this just a clip? I'm gonna have to go back. I'm personally curious about that. I think it is just an Exoforce hand. This looks really nice. $100 Ferris wheel, cheaper, available, or will be available, presently. Don't have to pay super aftermarket prices, and it actually turns. So pretty cool stuff there. And then the other one, interestingly, is yet another space shuttle. So this is called the 3-in-1 Space Shuttle Adventure, set number 31117. Hey, any Halo reference to this? Maybe there should be a Halo, like, back in the corner, just a little bit. 486 pieces. 486 is going to be a DX or a DX2? I have to ask. 486 pieces for this one. $50 or €50 for that. I like the shaping of the engine cowling back here, using that Disney Cars windscreen piece in white. Fits pretty well. I mean, you're going to have some sharp edges in there, but it fits pretty well. I'm just surprised that they're doing another one already. Obviously, this is based on an American space shuttle system, but then they've got the colors that kind of go with the rest of the semi-realistic, semi-futuristic space exploration stuff that they've done in the past couple of years. And then the rebuilds are a Saturn-style rocket. Saturn V-style rocket. And then a lunar lander. All realistic-ish. Which is shocking. That's really nice to be able to do such different things out of a single set. Now, this is not going to use many pieces. You're going to have so many pieces left over from this, especially plates. But this, it's so different. Such a different thing compared to this. I love that. I'm definitely going to be getting at least two copies of this, if not three. It's nice how smooth this is, also how they filled in the gap there at the end with the tiles to make sure that this closes up nicely. And the other picture shows exactly that. Shows you just how well it closes up. That's cool. Also, the nose cone is kind of nice. That uses a inverted round tile there. You got landing gear on this. They will not retract, I'm sure of that. But again, the engine cowling back here, this is nice. They even angled the vertical stabilizer appropriately. Reuse of that torso, that's fine. You know, just continue the series along. And you have a little, you could see it as a Hubble, but it's mostly gold, so maybe it's an antenna. Maybe it's supposed to be, I don't know. What exactly is this supposed to represent? Does the medium azure back there mean something? And are these trans purple 1x4s? Because they kind of look purple to me, not trans black or trans dark brown. That's interesting, but it looks good. I'm just kind of surprised that they're doing another small-ish shuttle again. We've had a number of things like this, but this is done pretty well. And $50 US feels like a lot to me for this amount of stuff. But considering the rest of this, I wonder if there will be pieces. I wonder how many pieces that they had to really embed into this and hide away to allow the build of the lunar lander, the full lunar lander there. You know, how many extra pieces the shuttle has to have within it that it maybe didn't need in order to pull this off. I think there's value to that, even if the shuttle itself, the main build itself, doesn't look like $50 worth of stuff. But to me, still, this looks more like a $40 set, just to my eyes. At most, I would prefer $30 based on that volume of stuff. We'll have to see how that turns out. But that's it. Just those two sets. I had more thoughts on these than others because I kind of understand the material a little bit better. I like realistic stuff. I like city stuff. I like space stuff. So there you go. Let me know what you think about these, and if you have any other information, feel free to share in the comments down below, and I'll talk to you again soon. Bye-bye.